He is a reward for his people.
Hi, my name is Colin Lee. I'm the reporter for Group 3 on the sleep detector experiment. Here's the template of the experiment. First, let me talk a little bit about what we did on the experiment. We tweaked the intake valve and the delivery valve while keeping the suction valve open until we have water flowing in from the suction tank and steam flowing in from the intake valve. And then we adjust the water intake valve until it stabilizes with the suction tank, and we record temperature and pressure of the steam intake valve, the pipe, suction pipe, and the delivery pipe. After that, we open the drain to the delivery tank while measuring the time taken for the water to rise 15 centimeters. Now to come in and measure the steam. The first method was to use the mass balance equation, where Q intake plus Q steam equals to Q out, and Q out equals the volume over time taken, 0.958 given in the lab manual, which is liter per centimeters times 15 centimeters divided by time taken for water to rise 15 centimeters. The volume is the result. As you can see, we got the Q steam. Second method is the energy balance method. Here we use the Lewis principle. We assume that the pipe lies in the same z coordinate axis and simplify the equation. We have P1, P2, and P3. In order to find P2 and P3, we use m dot equals the density times velocity times area. And area can be calculated using the diameters given. Here's the calculated result. We have M2 and M3. We managed to calculate P2 and V3, and P1, P2, V3 are given. So plugging it all into the equation, we find P1 and we use N dot equals to density times velocity times area. We get N dot 1. As you can see, N dot 1 plus N dot 2 is not equals to N dot 3. Here, I think it could be my calculation, or it could be an efficiency loss. Here we have the efficiency of injector as one kilo pump. I use the temperature in equals to the temperature inlet plus temperature suction divided by 2, and temperature out equals to the temperature of the delivery pipe. The efficiency is the T out divided by T in, and same goes with the efficiency of the pump. I use about the same thing. Here's a graph of the flow rate versus inlet pressure. I took data from the other groups, and as you can see, as the liquid flow rate increases, the inlet pressure increases as well. Same goes with the delivery pressure. Some of the groups got zero pressure at the start, simply because the water is not flowing. Any questions?
So like you said you use different methods, like did you have the problem of water hammering as the other group did, or?
Yes.
And like you came across like a choke flow or like calculated mass flow rates, like with different methods? Yeah, so was there the existence of a choke flow in the case? That minimum mass flow rate, what does that mean?
Which one? M1?
Yeah.
The M1 is the mass flow rate of the steam into the inlet pipe. That's from the regular equation. That much, that's the right equation.